ओम सर्व वेदांत सिद्धांत गोचरम तम गोचरम गोविंदम परमानंदम सद्गुरुम प्रणतोस्म्यहम्। गोइंग आफ्टर एंड्रियल ऑब्जेक्ट इज द काज ऑफ बॉन्डेज, सो दिस मैसेज शुड गिव इट अप। स्वयं आई एम अहम अस्मि इति अबाउट हिमसेल्फ ही शुड नो दैट आई एम दिस ब्रह्मन। आत्मदृष्ट्या एव ही शुड सी ब्रह्मन एज हिज ओन सेल्फ एंड विद दैट व्यू ही शुड स्टे स्टेडफास्टली विद द नॉलेज दैट ही इज ब्रह्मन। ब्रह्मणि निष्ठा सानुभूत्या, दैट मीन्स व्हेन द ब्रह्मन हैज बीन एक्सपीरियंस्ड एंड वी आर स्टेडफास्ट इन दैट व्यू, then it gives bliss, sukhayati. No, really, sanubhutya brahmani nishtha, it is not only a theoretical brahmani nishtha, but brahman has been experienced, not yet realized, and at that time, steadfastness in that anubhuti will give you bliss ultimately. अरति परम अविद्या कार्य दुखम प्रतीतम, दुख विच यू आर फीलिंग नाउ प्रतीतम दुखम, द दुख विच यू आर फीलिंग नाउ और यू हैव फेल्ट अप टिल नाउ इज द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ रॉन्ग नॉलेज, अविद्या कार्यम दुखम एंड दैट अविद्या विल बी परम अरति, इट विल टोटली डिस्ट्रॉय, इट विल टोटली टेक अवे दिस steadfastness in the experience of Brahman, giving up the external thought will give you bliss and will remove forever the effect of wrong knowledge which you are seeing now. Maya anusandhi parivarda yet phalam दुर्वासनामेव ततस्ततोदिकां ज्ञात्वा विवेकै परिरुच्य बाह्यं स्वात्मानुसन्धिं विदधीत नित्यं। बाह्य अनुसन्धि, सेम वर्ड इज रिपीटेड, गोइंग आफ्टर द एक्सटर्नल विल इंक्रीज द रिजल्ट ऑफ सच गोइंग एंड दैट इज दुर्वासन। रॉन्ग इंप्रेशंस बैड डिजायर्स ततस्तत्व अधिकां, दे विल गो ऑन इंक्रीजिंग, देर दे विल गो ऑन इंक्रीजिंग इफ यू अलाउ माय अनुसंधि, देन द रिजल्ट विल बी दैट दुर्वासनमेव अधिकां ततस्तत्व। सो व्हाट यू शुड डू, ज्ञात्वा विवेकै थ्रू डिस्क्रिमिनेशन यू शुड नो what is not your real nature as described up till now and giving it up parirutya swatmanusandhim, same word anusandhan comes here, going after your own real nature vidadita nityam, that should be your daily exercise. Maye niruddhe manasa prasannata mana prasade paramatma darshanam तस्मिन् सुदृष्टे भव बंधनाशो बहिर्निरोधः पदवी विमुक्ते। सो व्हेन द एक्सटर्नल बिकम्स स्टॉप टोटली, व्हेन गोइंग टू द आउटसाइड वर्ल्ड फॉर सम बिट ऑफ जॉय विल बी स्टॉप्ड टोटली, प्रसन्नता द हार्ट विल कम इन अ ट्रैंक्विल स्टेट। And when the heart is tranquil, manasa prasade paramatma darshan, you will have the vision of the Lord. This means sudrishte, when that vision becomes perfect. Sudrishte, when the vision of paramatma becomes perfect, then and the result will follow. Bhava bandha nasho, the bandhan of the samsara will be destroyed forever. When that anubhava becomes one. Bahir nirodha padavi vimukte. So he has shown from stopping the external up to reaching bliss. So he says that that is the padavi, that is the first step. Not allowing the mind to go outside will be the first step when one understands this. And that is the first step towards freedom or liberation. That means if you want to liberate yourself, first of all, stop this externalization. Panditasan sadasadviveki kriti pramana paramartha darshi janane kuryat asato valambam sapata heto shishuvanu mukhyo. Who is really called a pandit? Not one who has studied books, but one is filled of discrimination between the real and the unreal. He is a real pandit who has discrimination between real and unreal. Also some more qualities of pandit. Shruti Pramana, he accepts Shruti or Vedavakyas or Rishi's Vakyas only as the real means of knowledge. Authoritative means of knowledge are only the Rishi Vakyas. That is what he thinks, not his own thinking. Not other scholars thinking, not poets thinking, only the Rishi Vakyas he accepts as the supreme authority of truth, Paramartha Darshi. And then he has habituated himself only to see, experience the ultimate reality. He is Pandit. Pandit is one who is discriminate between real and unreal, who accept the Shrutis as the ultimate proof of everything, and he has become Darshi. That is called Shil Pratyaya. His nature has become that. He always wants to see the ultimate. Janani Kuryad Asatva Avalamban. On the other hand, always these two darshan. On the other hand, even after knowing that this is unreal, if you take resort to that, so pata heto, that is for your own falling down. Shishuvat mumukshu. It will be like a child who does not know anything and he may fall down. So for the mumukshu, this knowing the that taking resort to unreal will make me go down, one should give it up. That is the cause of your downfall. So like a child, don't be like a ignorant child, but be wise and follow the path laid up till now. Dehade samsakti matonam tir muktasya dehatma abhimati abhava suptasya no jagaranam na jagrata sapnastayor bhinna gunava gunashrayatvam. If you have attachment to the body, etc., body, indriyas, mind, and external objects, na mukti, you can't get freedom. One who is free, dehadi abhimati abhav, in him, there, about there, etc., the I feeling is absent. In whom the I feeling in body, etc., is absent, he is free. Lokic example he gives that for the man who is sleeping, Jagruti has no value. For a man who is waking up, Sapna and deep sleep, they have no value. In this way, Vinna Gunashrayo, they are of a different nature, they are of a different nature. So he has no value for sapna or sushupti in waking state. The man in this sleep does not have the pramana of the waking state. So like that, it is categorically different, the unreal and the real. Antar bahiswam sirajangameshu jnatvatmana narataya vilokya yakya khilopadi akhanda rupaha purnatmanaya siteva mukta. So he defines now mukti. Inside or outside? Are objects stationary or moving? Knowing that, atmana adharate. Know through yourself that the base of all this is Brahman, and give up all the upadhis. Upadhis are defined again and again. That which is not real nature but appears as your real nature is called upadhi. So all such things without exception you should give up. And akhanda rupa purnatmana yastita. Yeah, one who can stay as unbroken, perfect in that sense. When one can stay unbroken, perfect nature, then he only is mukta. He is only liberated, not one who talks. Sarvatmana bandha vimukti hetu sarvatma bhavanna parosti kaschit grishyagrahe sati upapaddate sau sarvatma bhavosya sadatma nishtaya. Sarvatmata, feeling identity with all, feeling identity with everything in the universe, that is the immanential reality. Bandha vimukti hetu, become the cause of freedom from the bondage. There has to be a bondage, and freedom from the bondage comes only when the sarvatmana, when we stay, when we realize our identification with the entire universe. There is nothing beyond this sarvatma bhava, because it comes after transcendence in nirvikalpa samadhi. In nirvikalpa samadhi, when we directly perceive the absence of the world, then we get confirmed in that. And then when we open our eyes, we feel that nothing other than me exists. That is the sarvatma. And that is the cause of freedom from bandhan. There is nothing beyond that. Grishya agrahe sati. Grishya agrahe sati. Grishya agrahe sati upapaddate asa. This comes by not accepting something which is seen. If you don't accept object as the object of perception, then only this thing can come. Sarvatma bhavo asya sadatma nishtaya. Sat is Brahman. When the Brahman is felt as I, and one is steadfast in that, then sarvatma bhav comes, he becomes one with all, and when that comes, so drishya is not accepted. When drishya is not accepted, then this sarvatma bhav comes. You can read it any side, sadatma nishtaya, by becoming steadfast in the realization that I am Brahman. ग्रीष्यस्य ग्रहणं कथं न घटते देहात्मना तिष्ठतो बाह्यार्थानुभव प्रसक्त मनसा तत्तत् क्रिया कुर्वता सन्न्यस्ताखिल धर्म कर्म विषय नित्यात्मनिष्ठा परैर तत्त्वज्ञै करणीयमात्मनि सदा नन्देच्चु वीर्यत्नता. So what one should do in such a state? If you stay taking the body to be yourself, then how can you? Previously he said, don't accept object. How can you stay without accepting the object if you take body as yourself? So the very fact of taking body as myself means there are objects. You cannot deny them. Katham nu ghatate, how can it happen? Then what will happen? Vayartha anubhava prasakta manasa. The mind will remain attached to the experience of the external objects. And tattat kriya kurvata, then that type of action will follow. In such a state, how can you give up the drishyas agrahanam? On the other hand, sannyasta akila dharma karma vishaye. Dharma, achieving punya, includes achieving paap. Karma, doing karma for getting some result. Akila, total, sannyasta, giving up. Vishaye, the field of nityatma nishtha parehi, and being permanently steadfast in Atman, Tattva Gyai, and realizing the real nature of everything, Tattva Gyai. What he should do? What he should do means he has not yet realized. Atmani sada nende chubir yatnata. If you want permanent bliss, sadananda, then yatnata karaniyam atmani karaniyam. Pari nishtha kartavyam karaniyam. So those who want the permanent bliss should in themselves being steadfast in the habit of looking for the ultimate reality, the ultimate Atmanishtha, by giving up sannyasta akila dharma karma vishayi, the field of all punya pap and karma has to be given up by one who wants the permanent bliss. That is the shloka. सर्वात्म सिद्धये भिक्षो कृत श्रवण कर्मणः समाधिं विदधात्येष शांतो दान्त इति श्रुतिः. Here more clearly he mentions भिक्षो सन्यासी कृत श्रवण कर्मण. He has done the work of hearing, so the knowledge has come in him. But what he wants is सर्वात्म सिद्धि, being established as the being of all. What he should do? He should do samadhi. He should remain absorbed, one-pointed, in his feeling of the real nature of Atman. That is what he should do. If he has completed hearing, that means he knows the truth now theoretically, he should meditate upon it. He should absolutely meditate upon that. He should remove everything else from his meditation. That is nididhyasan. And if he is a sannyasi, he can do that. And this has been described in the Shruti as Shanta, Danta, etc. Shanta means having mental control, Danta means having physical control. So Shruti through this passage is realizing Samadhi for realizing the identity of the universal with the self. Esha, through the word Shanto, Danta, etc., Shruti is prescribing Samadhi Vidadati Esha. This Samadhi is being prescribed for him if he has completed the work of his hearing. So Manan in between has been done along with Shravana, and he should do Nididhasana regularly. Arudha Shakter Ahamo Vinasha Kartun Nashakya Sahasapi Panditai Ye Nirvikalpakya Samadhi Nishala Stanantaranantamavahi Vasana. Very clearly he states here. He will state still more strongly about the so-called theoretical knowledge of Brahma. This aham is Arudha Shakti. Aham has gained great power in our life, and we want to destroy that. It is not possible even for a scholar. Even for a scholar, this destruction of I is not possible because this I has gained tremendous power. Then, not impossible. Ye nirvikalpa ke samadhi nishchala. There is a samadhi called nirvikalpa. There, where other than Brahman, neither I nor anything of the world remains, that is nirvikalpa. That samadhi nishchala. One who is steadfast in that samadhi. And antara, other than them, ananta bhavahi vasana, endless are the desires, endless are the past impressions, endless are the desires for others who have not undergone nirvikal steadfastness in nirvikalpa samadhi. Because this aham has become so strong that even a man of so-called knowledge cannot suddenly destroy it. Only when in the nirvikalpa samadhi we see the absence of I and the world, then only this can happen. Otherwise, ananta bhavahi vasana. Inside, there will be infinite desires and impressions. First clear mention of nirvikalpa samadhi has come. Aham buddhaiva mohinya yojaitva puruter balat vikshepa shakti purusham vikshepa yati tat gunai. What is happening in our life, even in the life of the meditator? Avruter balat aham buddha eva Vikshepa Shakti Mohinya Yojaitva. On the strength of Brahman being covered, on the strength of non-perception of Brahman, this high consciousness, which is the delusing force, it makes the Vikshepa Shakti work. The Avrut, when the covering mode of wrong knowledge has given rise to I consciousness, which is very deluding thing, that employs the Vikshepa Shakti and it distracts the Purusha with its effect. Tad gunaihi Vikshepa yati Purusham. Tadgunai means Vikshepa Shakti is guna, is the entire world. So Avarna Shakti has covered. In that condition, the Aham Buddhi deludes the man and the Vikshepa Shakti goes on giving us addiction to the non-existing things, and this is for every Purusha. If he has progressed a lot, then also. If he has not progressed, then also. That is the condition. Vikshepa Shakti Vijayo Vishayo Vishamo Vidhatum Nishyeshama Varana Shakti Nivrutya Bhave Drigdrishayo Sputapayo Jalavad Vibhago Vibhage Nashetada Varana Matmani Chasavavad Nisamshayena Bhavati Pratibandha Shunyo Vikshepanam Nahi Tada Yadi Chen Vrushartha. If the Avarani Shakti has not been got rid of totally, Vikshepa Shakti you cannot conquer. It is extremely difficult or impossible to conquer the Vikshepa Shakti, the projecting power, because you have not been able to conquer the Avarani Shakti. So when the Avarani Shakti functions, the Vikshepa Shakti will function. Vishesha, totally it will not go. Now, Drigdrishayo Vivage. Then you can clearly see what are objects and what is the consciousness looking at those objects. As water and milk they are mist, and the Supreme Swan can separate them. If you can separate like that, the drishya and drishta, then avaranam atmanicha svabhavat naschet. Then by its nature, that which is covering the atman will go away, and then only vikshep shakti can stop. So long as avarani shakti is there, vikshep shakti is working and causing all the effects of putting it as into sansara. One, as the swan discriminates between milk and water, in that way, if we can separate, discriminate between the seen and the witness, then only this, by its very nature, the avaran will go. And then, without doubt, you will become free from any obstacles. Yadi ched mrushartha vikshepanam nahi tada. For unreal objects, if they are not distracting you, mutual dependence. Unless avarani is distracted, vikshepa will not go. And if vikshepa is distracting you, then you cannot become free from obstacles. But if you can insist upon the discrimination, then without obstruction, you will get your realization, and then the tendency towards the Vikshepa Shakti itself will not remain. Sambhag Viveka Sputabodha Janyo Vivajya Drigrishya Padartha Tattvam Chinatti Mayakrita Mohajatam Yasmad Vimuktasya Punarna Sanskriti. So he is now indicating there will come a state when we will be totally free permanently. That indication is being given now and there. If you have real discrimination, born out of Sputa Bodha, your consciousness has changed. Very clearly, you can discriminate by separating the drishya padartha from the drishta. Then only maya krita moha bandham chinatti. Then this bondage of delusion produced by Maya will be destroyed. Because in the case of a Mukta Purush, there is not going to be any transmigration. So, if Sputabodha Janya Samvivek has come, then Drishta Drishya Padartha, you will always be separated for you, and the Maya Kruta Moha Bandhan will be destroyed, and never can ignorance come again. So, there is a state of permanency. It is not infinite progress so far, but till then you have to struggle. Till you become established in that state where it does not come again, then you are free. Paravarair katva viveka vannir dahat kavidya ghanam yashesham kim syat puna sansaranasya bijam advaita bhavam samagve ishosya. For one who has got the advaita bhav, then this world and Brahman being identical, that is the fire it will produce. You will not see the world other than Brahma. It is only Brahman in appearance. That discrimination will burn. Avidya ghanam hi ashesham. This avidya is like a forest. And this deep forest will be burned by that discrimination, which is being prescribed from the beginning. So if you have got the Advaita Bhav, the very seed of transmigration has gone. Himsyat Puna. How can it come again? The seed of transmigration has gone. That will happen if you have achieved the Advaita Bhav. Avaranasya Nivruttir Bhavatihi सम्यक् पदार्थ दर्शनता मिथ्या ज्ञान विनाश तद विक्षेप जनित दुख निवृत्ति सम्यक् पदार्थ दर्शनता व्हेन यू राइटली सी द रियलिटी देन आवरण विल नॉट रिमेन एंड आवरण हैविंग गॉन द मिथ्या ज्ञान विनाश विल हैपन द डिस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द wrong knowledge will also happen. The vikshepa janita dukkha nivruti. And then the dukkhas being produced by the vikshepa shakti will also vanish. Eta tritayam drishtam samyak rajya swarupa vijnanat tasmad vastu satatvam gyatavyam bandha vimukti Panda Muktaye Vidusha. Example I use, there is a rope and appearance of snake. Now, if the rope knowledge is not covered, then the appearance is not possible. It is covered, then only appearance comes. But if you can clearly see the rope, then the avarana is not remaining, and the wrong knowledge also is vanishing, and the dukkha which you are receiving, seeing the snake, will also gone. So, Eta Tritayam, these three. Three, Avarani Shakti, Vikshepa Shakti, and its result, Dukkha. These three. Raju Swarupa Vijnana. When you know the real nature, that is robe, when you see that clearly, then this will happen, that these three, the appearance of the serpa, and the problems coming from it and the rope being covered, all this will vanish when you know the real nature of the rope. Therefore, tasmat, vidusha, by the man of knowledge, this knowledge, bandhamuktaye, if he wants to get rid of the bandhanas, he should know the satatvam, the reality. So, again and again, fix your mind in the reality. That is the way. When you will achieve that, then the other things will go. Ayogni yogat yuvasat samanvayat matradi rupena vijrumbate dhi tat karyametat dvitayam yato mrusha drishtam brahmasvapna manorateshu tato vikara prakrute ahamukha deha vasana vishyascha sarve kshanenatha bhavitaya yamisha asattvam atma tu kadapi nanyatha. Ayogni yoga diva, a iron ball being heated in fire. Sat samanvaya diva, like this, sat samanvaya. So, being associated with Brahman, our buddhi, our eye consciousness, matra de rupena virumate, it becomes the indriya, etc. It manifests itself as the indriyas, which go on measuring things of the world. And that possesses duality. The perception of subject and object is caused by our eye consciousness appearing through the indriyas, just like the iron ball heated in fire. As this is unreal, just like we see in a delusion, just like we see in dream, just like we see in high-flown ideas of the mind, that all that is illusion. Similarly, this duality itself, which is the product of eye consciousness, is also unreal. And from that, vikara prakrutir ammukha. From all this, what happens? Our real nature is destroyed, as if we get modifications from nature, starting from I, my mind, my indriyas, all these things come. They have asana, right up to I am the body. And not only that, vishyasya sarve, I am attached to all the objects of the world. From this adnana comes this I am. From this I am comes body. And with this body, all objects of the world, this is what happens. Ane anyatha bhavitaya hi amisham asattvam. But if you critically see, every moment they change. Every moment I and my body and the indriyas and the objects of the world change every moment. So the way to be firm in knowledge is that to observe the momentariness of all this. And from that one should conclude there and there. They can never be myself. They are unreal. They can never be myself. There is no other way. Kadapi na anyatha. Nitya dvaya khanda chideka rupo buddha adi sakshi sadasad vilakshana अहम पद प्रत्यय लक्षितार्थ प्रत्यक्ष सदानंद घन परात्मा नित्य अद्वय अखंड चित एक रूपो विच इज द विटनेस ऑफ बुद्धादि साक्षी द आई कॉन्शियसनेस एंड माई माइंड ऑल दिस इज नोन विटनेस बाय माई रियल कॉन्शियसनेस इट इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम सद और असद फ्रॉम ग्रॉस और सटल ऑब्जेक्ट्स इट इज वेरी डिफरेंट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स नाउ व्हाट कम्स इफ वी अटर द वर्ड अहम What comes? We should find the implied meaning when we say I. When we say I, what comes is body, mind, and etc. But on analysis, as been already described, we should find that is Lakshya Artha, the indicated meaning is Pratyak Sadananda Ghana Paratma. The ultimate reality. Which is the congealed form of existence and joy, which is inside me, that should come when we utter the word aham. This is akhanda, chit, ekarupa, buddhyadi sakshi, sadasad vilakshana. This, all this is the aham pada pratyaya lakshitartha. He has already described that if aham pada is from that we go to the indicated meaning, this is the meaning we'll get. Itham vipaschit sadasad vivajya nishchitya tattvam nijabodha drishtya jnatva samatmanam akhanda bodham tebhyo vimukta swayameva shamyati. So the man of knowledge should discriminate the real from the unreal and be firm about the ultimate reality by his own changed consciousness, nija bodha drishtya. By the changed consciousness, he should see what is his real nature. And he will know that I am nothing but the akhanda consciousness of my own Atman. Then tebhyo vimukta, then you will get free from all the wrong knowledges. Svayameva shamyati, automatically they will go down. So if you are steadfast in your real nature, always discriminating, then the other part should drop automatically. We are now coming nearer to अज्ञान हृदय ग्रंथे निशेष विलयस्तदा समाधिना अविकल्पेन यदा द्वैतात्म दर्शनम निर्विकल्प हैज बीन कॉल्ड अविकल्प अज्ञान रॉन्ग नॉलेज इज द नॉट इन द हार्ट विच हैज टाइड द कॉन्शियसनेस टू द मैटर एंड फ्रॉम दैट नॉट सेवरल नॉट्स हैव कम कॉम्प्लेक्सेस This knot will be destroyed permanently, totally by samadhi, by nirvikalpa samadhi. By nirvikalpa samadhi, you will have clear perception of Advaita Atma Darshan, that the self without any duality will be clearly perceived through nirvikalpa samadhi. And then the Hridaya Granthi will go and all other problems will go, not till then. I think we can up here. 353 is started from 333. 353, 21 shloka. I think we can stop here. So now the topic has slightly shifted from Nididhyasana. The emphasis on the necessity of Nirvikalpa Samadhi, that has become the topic now. And let me tell something I told you. Let me tell by name. There is a school of thought. They call them Harsha Vidyalaya. And they openly preach that there is nothing called meditation, that there is nothing called samadhi, there is nothing called aparoksha anubhav. If we listen to Vedanta Pramas, you are a Vedanti. And encounter with these people. And they wrongly quoted Veka Chudamani in support of them. Then I quoted several stanzas from Veka Chudamani, as you are seeing now. Still more stronger stanza will come in Veka Chudamani. And Veka Chudamani tells us, meditate, have absolute absorption in samadhi, have aparoksha anubhav, non-indirect, more direct than direct realization, then only you are mukta, not till then. So this thing is being emphasized now in this portion of the topic becomes Nirvikalpa Samadhi, and various arguments, various statements are being made rather, that without this you cannot realize your real nature. Till then it is talk, talk and talk only. So that is the topic going on. We'll take it up on the next occasion and see how it culminates, how Shankara strongly condemns those who think that intellectual assimilation is enough. Shankara has outright condemned them in Veka Chudamani. So we shall come to that topic in the next occasion. We can stop it here today at Shloka 353. Om Sarva Vedanta Siddhanta Gocharam Tama Gocharam Govindam Paramanandam Satgurum Pranatosmyam. Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Tat Sat Shri Ramakrishna Arpanamastu.